And we straight away cut across to breaking news coming in. ED has arrested Vinay Mishra's brother, Bikash Mishra. He was arrested in Delhi. He has been produced before the court, sent to 6 days remand. Allegedly, the family received around 31 crore rupees. Straight away bringing in Shavan Sen, who's picking up more details on the same. Over to you, Shavan.
Well, this is a big development in the coal smuggling case where we even to understand that a TMC youth leader, Vinay Mishra's brother, Vikas Mishra, has now been arrested from the national capital. In fact, he has already been produced before the court, where he has been sent to 6 days of remand. They're being told that the enforcement directorate, in its preliminary investigation, has found out that the entire family has allegedly received about 31 crore rupees. That's the allegation that has been leveled against the family members. In fact, remember, Vinay Mishra has also been under the scanner of the enforcement directorate. The agency has now recovered a diary in which there is a mention of the transaction amount that has actually taken place and the cut money that was basically being received by Vinay Mishra. Vinay Mishra, who is already on the run right now, has been under the scanner of not just the enforcement directorate, but also the Central Bureau of Investigation. In fact, there is a red corner, red notice that has already been issued, is what we are being told. Because remember, his brother, Vikas Mishra's brother, Vinay Mishra, it is suspected, left the country sometime early September and thereafter traveled to multiple countries through a fake passport. In fact, he traveled from the national capital first to Dubai and then two other countries. We are being told one happens to be Bangladesh and the other is South Africa. As far as Vikas Mishra is concerned, important to point out is that he did actually appear before the agencies, at least before the Central Bureau of Investigation for questioning. Sources within that agency indicated that Vikas Mishra wasn't really cooperating with the agency. Having said that, after a few days, he stops responding to the summons that were being sent out, one by the Central Bureau of Investigation and second from the Enforcement Directorate. Thereafter, we're now being told that the Enforcement Directorate, after a lookout notice was issued, has arrested Vikas Mishra from the national capital.
Shavan, I want you to break down all the details because this is a huge impact of the coal scam sting that was first put out by Republic Bangla and the deeper nexus that it exposed. Vipul, one of the kingpins of the Bengal coal scam who runs the business for top politicians, collected hundreds of crores of rupees every month, and how this was never exposed by the Bengal media earlier. Republic Bangla first put out this story that created ripples. The agency sought these tapes and now this is a huge impact. What next, Shavan? What are you picking up from your sources?
Well, at this point in time, important to find out right now would be where exactly is Vinay Mishra, the man who has been on the run, the man who is certainly suspected to have a political link, or rather political patronage to carry out the smuggling, be it coal smuggling or for that matter, the cattle smuggling that has taken place so far. Vinay Mishra, he hasn't responded to any of the summons that were sent out. In fact, there is already a charge sheet that has been filed by the Central Bureau of Investigation and based on which the CBI has already approached the court for a non-bailable warrant. A non-bailable warrant has already been issued and thereafter the CBI has already approached what we are given to understand is the Interpol so that he could a red notice could be issued. And thereafter, any member nation of Interpol could actually place Vinay Mishra under arrest. So for that matter, the arrest of Vikas Mishra becomes extremely important because that would perhaps lead to some sort of a clue or a lead in this entire matter.
But Shavan, let's not forget that Vipul is a middleman working for the TMC youth wing leader Vinay Mishra and he is currently absconding. Now, even as you tell us that Bikash Mishra was arrested in Delhi, and who are the others who are under the scanner, under the radar of the agencies? Bikash Mishra's whereabouts in Delhi, what are the other links that they've managed to unearth?
Well, as far as the kingpin of the coal smuggling is concerned, Anup Maji is the other person who still remains under the scanner of both the agencies, and he still hasn't been arrested either of the agencies at this point in time. Having said that, what becomes very crucial right now is to basically find out the link, one, as to how exactly did Vinay Mishra travel from the national capital to another country. Our sources, agencies indicate that sometime early September is when he fled from the country. That to taking a flight using a fake passport is what we are being told. Apart from that, as far as Bikash Mishra is concerned, remember, Bikash Mishra was someone who was appearing before the Central Bureau of Investigation. It now turns out that during the investigation, several seizures were actually made by the Enforcement Directorate, in which a diary, which makes a mention of certain transactions, in which a transaction of about 31 crore is what we are being told, the family of Vinay Mishra actually received. Now, the money actually came in from whom is still not known at this point in time. Because remember, this is at a very preliminary stage. So it remains to be seen how exactly would the investigation pan out.
Shravan, I also want to take this one line that was said in Vipul in that sting that Republic Bangla had put out, where he said that I don't manage it alone. Others are there. Bengal police sometimes creates problems and files cases under various sections. They harass us, but they can't do anything more. Now, obviously, they have functioned under the shield of...
Joining us also on the phone line right now is Arjun Singh of the BJP. Arjun Singh sahab, sabse pehle to ye bahut bada impact hai ki ek din baad Republic Bangla ke sting ke baad jahan pe saaf tarike se humne dikhaya ki kis tarah se ye pure koila smuggling ke sath aur cattle smuggling ke jo log kingpin hai kis tarah se unhe kahin na kahin political support aur kahin na kahin police support bhi mila hai. Aaj Bikash Mishra ka arrest hone ke baad kahin na kahin ye pure scam kahin na kahin aage nikal kar aayega.
देखिए रिपब्लिक बंगला ने जो साफ कदम उठाया है कि बंगाल के सारे मीडिया हिल गई है और लोग भी रिपब्लिक बंगला को माने सैल्यूट जनाएंगे कि आज तक किसी ने भी कोई एक मीडिया ने बंगाल में इस कोल जो स्कीम है इसके बारे में कभी भी कोई एक न्यूज तक नहीं छापती थी और आज स्टिंग ऑपरेशन के बाद आज उसके भाई को विनय मिश्रा के भाई को अगर ईडी ने अरेस्ट किया है तो एक बहुत बड़ा कदम है. बंगाल में कोल स्मगलिंग कोल जो के साथ हजारों हजारों करोड़ रुपया का जो सरकारी जो यहाँ की वर्तमान सरकार है जो डील करती थी जिनको पैसा मिलता था पुलिस वाले इसमें इन्वॉल्व है. 7-8 आईपीएस इसमें इन्वॉल्व है और सारे इंस्पेक्टर उस क्षेत्र के इन्वॉल्व रहते हैं. तो ये बहुत बड़ा आज रिपब्लिक जो बांग्ला के न्यूज के बाद स्टिंग के बाद ये दबाव मैं कहूंगा कि दबाव आया ऐसा पूरा कि आज उसके भाई को भी ईडी और सीबीआई ने गिरफ्तार कर लिया और ये बंगाल के बहुत बड़े नेक्सस जो पॉलिटिकल नेक्सस है इसके स्कीम में ये खुल के अब सामने आ जाएगा इसका विश्वास है बंगाल के लोगों
को. अर्जुन जी साहब और एक सवाल ये उठता है कि किस तरह से इतने दिनों तक सबसे पहले बंगाल की स्टेट सीआईडी इस पूरे मामले को जांच कर रहे थे पर कहीं ना कहीं ये नाम उभर कर नहीं आए थे और ये नाम के पीछे कोई जांच नहीं हुई थी. क्या आपको लगता है कि कहीं ना कहीं इंसाफ मिलेगा, कहीं ना कहीं आपको लगता है इस पूरे मामले के जड़ तक जाने की कोशिश की जाएगी?
बंगाल सीआईडी इस केस को फिर दबाने की कोशिश कर रही थी जिस तरह शारदा और रोज वैली केस में उस समय के एक सीट बनाया गया था जिसमें राजीव कुमार के नेतृत्व में तो वो स्कीम जो है ये अब जाके फिर ये साबित हो जाएगा कि सीट जो थी वो उन अपराधियों को बचाने के लिए किया गया था, उन पॉलिटिकल लोगों को बचाने के लिए किया गया था, न कि उसका तथ्य को जानकारी के लिए. ऐसे कोई बात नहीं है. ये पॉलिटिकल जो सरकारी पार्टी है और कुछ जो पुलिस अफसर हैं उनको बचाने के लिए ये सीट गठन किया गया था लेकिन सीबीआई और ईडी ने जो किया है ये काबिले तारीफ है और काबिले तारीफ आर बांग्ला को मैं सबसे ज्यादा दूंगा कि उन्होंने साहस करके स्टिंग ऑपरेशन करके ये दिखाया, बंगाल की जनता के सामने लाया, पूरे हिंदुस्तान के सामने आया इस बात को, कि इसके लिए धन्यवाद दूंगा.
अर्जुन सिंह साहब, रिपब्लिक बांग्ला से और रिपब्लिक टीवी से बात करने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। हमारे साथ इस वक्त और भी लोग जुड़े, राहुल सिन्हा बीजेपी से जुड़ रहे हैं। राहुल सिन्हा साहब, आपसे ये पूछना चाहेंगे कि जिस तरह से इतने सालों से इस पूरे मामले को दबाने की कोशिश की गई थी, इस किस तरह से सीबीआई को परमिशन नहीं दिया गया था, इसके बावजूद आज जो देखने मिल रहा है कि किस तरह से एक के बाद एक अरेस्ट हुए जा रहे हैं और लोग रिपब्लिक बांग्ला के एक्सपोजे के बाद सवाल ये उठाए जा रहे हैं कि आखिरकार इनको बचाया किसने था।
नहीं नहीं देखिए, इस मामला को तृणमूल ने दबाने का बहुत सारे प्रयास किया। कारण एक कोल कांड में तृणमूल का ऊपर तक इसमें शामिल है और इसीलिए आप तो देखिए निचला हिस्सा में चल रहा है, इसका भाई उसका ही उसको गिरफ्तार कर रहा है और कुछ ही दिन इस केस को आगे जाने दीजिए, जो बड़ा बड़ा जो हस्ती है इसमें सब इसमें फंस जाएंगे। कारण एक बड़ा घोटाला कोल का चला, लंबा समय से चला और इस घोटाला को जब ईडी ने उजागर करने का कोशिश किया या कोई माध्यम ने उजागर करने का कोशिश किया, सारे चीज को रोका गया पश्चिम बंग सरकार का ओर से। तो इसीलिए जब आज ईडी इसका छानबीन कर रहा है, देखिए साथ साथ वो राज्य स्वतंत्र एजेंसी सीआईडी को भी भेज दिया उसपे छानबीन करने के लिए। तो इतना दिन सीआईडी को क्यों नहीं भेजा, आज क्यों भेजा, जब देखा जे सारे तथ्य निकाल के आ जाएगा। और सीआईडी को इसलिए भेजा कि सीआईडी जाके सारे जो सबूत है उसको नष्ट कर दे, जैसे जैसे शारदा कांड में हमने देखा था सीआईडी जाके सीबीआई का पहले पहुंच के सारे सबूत को मिटा दिया, ऐसे मिटाने का काम किया।
राहुल सिन्हा साहब, पर आपके ऊपर भी बड़े संगीन आरोप लगता है, ये आरोप तृणमूल कांग्रेस ये लगाते हैं कि किस तरह से कहीं ना कहीं बीजेपी इलेक्शन के माहौल के बीच में सीबीआई और ईडी की इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं और उसके बाद कहीं ना कहीं तृणमूल कांग्रेस के ऊपर प्रेशर डाला जा रहा है। क्या आपको लगता है कि ये निष्पक्ष जांच हो रहा है? We'll try and reconnect with Rahul Sinha. On the one hand, you see the Tridamool Congress alleging that during the election season, you have the center essentially using the Enforcement Directorate as well as the Central Bureau of Investigation as tools. And this is a serious allegation that has been leveled by the Tridamool Congress. On the other hand, what you're looking at is some key developments actually taking place in the coal and the cattle smuggling case, in which the ED perhaps a late entrant as far as the investigation is concerned, but however has actually picked up several clues in this entire matter and also trying to join the dots. What we are picking up from our sources is, one, that the enforcement directed during the searches that were basically carried out just a few weeks ago at multiple locations, remember over 15 locations where searches were basically carried out, not just in Kolkata, but in several parts of the state where these searches were basically carried out. And thereafter, a perusal of all the documents, what the Enforcement Directorate has been calling incriminating evidence that they had basically gathered, after which they've come across certain diaries, certain diary entries were basically found out, in which they came across how the Mishra family, Vinay Mishra, a Tridamool Congress leader, had actually allegedly received funds of about 31 crore. Now, because Mishra has been arrested from the national capital, we are given to understand that he has been sent to 6 days of remand, in which the enforcement directed, while seeking his remand, has told the court that they want to investigate this entire matter, especially given the fact that they have come across certain leads indicating that Vikash Mishra and his brother Vinay Mishra had actually received money for during the coal smuggling, the period which has basically come under the scandal.
Well,
Well, this is a major arrest that has actually taken place with the Enforcement Directorate that has arrested Vinay Mishra's brother, Vikash Mishra. This comes just days after Republic Bangla had put out a sting operation of one of the kingpins who has actually taken the name of various people like Anup Maji, and for that matter, even Vinay Mishra and Vikash Mishra. Now, finally, Vikash Mishra, who's now been arrested by the Enforcement Directorate. The ED now also looking at who are the other characters who are basically involved in this entire cattle smuggling net. That becomes very crucial at this point in time. What the Enforcement Directorate is also looking at is that whether at all there was some sort of a political patronage that was given to this entire mafia, or else how would these operatives carry out this entire act of coal smuggling, in which the coal was being smuggled from the jurisdiction of the center. Remember, these areas where the searches were actually carried out, it turned out that how, due to the political as well as police patronage that was given, the entire coal and cattle smuggling mafia continues to work with impunity even today.